Hey, what's up guys? Today we're going to be turning my black honeypot ants red. Here I am filling their feeder with hummingbird nectar, which they love. And here you can take a look at the workers and see what they look like. These are mostly black with just slightly brown heads. And in this video, you can see the queen being tended to by the workers. There's a pile of eggs underneath her and they haven't been fed in a while. So let's give them the nectar and see what happens. When I placed the nectar in their outworld, they quickly started coming out and exploring to see what was going on. Shortly after, they found the source of the food, and they started walking all over the feeder as they drank up the sweet liquids. Let's see what happens when they bring it down to the rest of the colony. A couple of hours later, their stomachs were full and red of the hummingbird nectar. They do this to store food for the dry months since they're native to deserts. Follow me for more ant videos!
C'est une goutte d'eau sur une surface extrêmement chaude et surtout en ultra zoom. En fait, si la température de la cuillère dépasse les 160 degrés, et c'est le cas ici, l'effet Leidenfrost fait son apparition. La goutte, en fait, en touchant la surface, ne va pas s'étaler ni s'évaporer. Non, en fait, elle va rester parfaitement ronde et glisser tranquillement, comme si la surface était hydrophobe. L'effet en jeu ici est ultra stylé. Et en gros, lorsque l'eau entre en contact avec la cuillère chauffée, la partie inférieure de la goutte va se vaporiser, et cette couche de gaz, extrêmement fine, environ 1/10 de millimètre, va permettre à la goutte d'être isolée thermiquement pendant un certain temps. Et avec un objectif comme ça, ultra macro, c'est vraiment trop stylé à observer.
Son, how was your last day of 6th grade?
Pretty good. I'm glad my 1 year with Miss Frizzle's over.
Glad to hear it, son.
But I did have a weird interaction with her.
Like what?
Well, Miss Frizzle wanted to go on one last field trip with us, so she took us to the beginning of the universe, the Big Bang.
No.
So as we watched the last bits of matter collide that'll spark off our universe, Miss Frizzle looked at me and said, "Steven, the odds of the Big Bang happening are astronomically low, but the odds of me in my class are even lower."
No.
And then she smiles at me and says, "Steven, you like asking questions, so I have one for you.
Please, sensei.
How do you prove a good hypothesis?" So I obviously responded, "You
repeat it."
"Dad, why did she ask me that?"
"You got a difficult journey ahead."
"I thought I did my time. You do 1 year with Miss Frizzle, and you move on to the 7th grade.
Not a 7th grader. One of her favorites.
How is it so cold in that trailer? This is a reefer trailer. Reefer is shorthand for refrigerated trailer. This trailer is 13 feet 7 inches tall and 53 feet long.
This is the reefer unit. Much like your thermostat at home, if you set it to a certain temperature, it'll keep it for the remainder of your trip. You can set it at 65 degrees all the way down to negative 40 degrees. Once the temperature is set, the reefer motor turns on, blowing in cold air and kicking out hot air.
Without these insulated reefer trailers, we would never be able to transport food from one side of the country to the other.
This, you forgot one thing. Your scale video did over 1 million views. For real?
What? Thank you. To celebrate, there's an adorable shirt that says, "Let's scale it" in my bio. Go get it. Thank you guys so much for all the love.
Do you believe me if I said these two jars held the same amount of water? If you said no, you would be correct.
Do you have ADHD? Do you want to know one of the reasons why your brain sucks? Yeah, you do. Let's do this. There exists a set of regions in your brain that is very active when you're not doing anything. It's called the default mode network, and it's your chillin' brain. Now, there's another network in your brain called the task positive network. Now, the task positive network is the part of your brain that lights up when you do have stuff to do, when you're doing stuff. Your default mode network is supposed to calm down as your task positive network ramps up. But you know what an ADHD person's default mode network does? Not that! Our chillin' brain remains very active, even when we're trying to do stuff. However, certain research has shown that an ADHD person's default mode network will subside if the task is sufficiently stimulating, which supports the idea that an ADHD person can focus, but only if they find the task interesting.
Follow for more ADHD content.
The Atlantic and Pacific Oceans meet, but do not mix. Now what causes this? Because everyone in the comments is saying God is good, praise Allah. Is this an act of God, or is it because the oceans have two separate densities and don't combine?
So here at the South Pole, it is currently negative 86 Fahrenheit. I thought it'd be a good time to go see the pole marker because the last time I saw it, there's still a little bit of sunlight on the horizon, but now we've been in total darkness for about 2 months. We're just past the full moon now, so we've got a lot of light outside. right, so here I am at the actual geographic South Pole right here. The whole globe spins around this spot. We've got a little sign saying that it's the geographic South Pole, American flag. Behind me back over here, you can see the elevated station where we all live and work. So you can see we're actually not that far from the pole, maybe 200 meters or so to walk out here.
I have struggled to tell the idea that time is the fourth dimension, and to make it in a way that people would understand, and it's been hard to get that under a minute. This morning, TikTok gave me 3-minute videos, so please stay till the end. I know it's hard to understand, but I think you'll find it enlightening, and I've made this as, I think I've found a way to explain it to people who've really struggled to understand the fourth dimension. Okay, so this apple is a very special apple because it is sentient. We have granted it the awareness of its own existence. We have granted it memory. However, it can only perceive in two-dimensional space. Okay, so how does it see itself? And some people would say, like a picture or a photograph or a reflection in a mirror, those are two-dimensional representations of three-dimensional space. This object doesn't understand the third dimension, so representing the third dimension won't mean anything to it. It can only perceive in two dimensions at a time, so it must perceive itself in two-dimensional slices of itself. Okay, so those slices, as it explores its own existence and moves across itself, it will actually be to its own purpose that slice. So in the beginning, it is just a bit of skin. It doesn't see itself, that bit of skin, as being part of a larger whole. It sees itself as being a bit of skin, and that is what it is. And then, as it explores itself, it sees itself as growing and changing, and then coming down. We, of course, know, no, it's just a piece of you. It's not the whole. It doesn't see it that way, okay? So in the beginning, I am a bit of skin. I am a bit of skin and fruit. I am a bit of skin. I'm mostly fruit and a little bit of skin. I am almost all fruit. And then suddenly, I have seeds. I'm sentimental. I imagine the part when the apple has seeds, it would think that's a magical part of its existence. And then as it nears the end, though, it starts to get afraid because it will stop existing. The way it travels across the third dimension, exploring itself, it has no concept of anything beyond, and it will just cease to exist. Who can see the third dimension, go, no, you're there. You're there in the third dimension. You exist. You're not just slices, but it doesn't know that. It can't know that. So we are in four-dimensional space, space and time, and we can only perceive three dimensions. So how do we see that fourth dimension? We see it in three-dimensional slices. Okay, and each slice we call the present. And those slices stack up in our memory and they become a construct we call time. And we conceive of ways where it might extend past our own existence because we don't want the universe to exist without us in it. But all of us has always been in all of the universe.
Is Fiji acidic or alkaline?
You know what she said to me? She said, you're a player, aren't you? And I bet you got hoes. I said, you don't know me like that. I just go with the flow. She said, you can't fool me like that.
Neutral.
You're